Now we go to the criminal investigation and what caused the mosquito fire, which started in Placer County and then spread to El Dorado County. Investigators say they've taken a PG&E transmission pole after learning the fire happened near the utility's power line. Let's go to Live Copter 3 right now. This is the area where the fire started about 3 weeks ago. This is near Oxbow Reservoir, where they were pulling water to fight those flames. The fire has burned more than 76,000 acres. It is now 85% contained. Let's go to KCRA3's Orko Manna joining us live right now in Forest Hill. Orko, you're at Wharton's Market, which has served as a hub for fire crews fighting the mosquito fire. What's it looking like today? You were out here when the fire was still up and going in this area.
That's right, Ty. Well, just a couple of weeks ago, we saw the flames of the mosquito fire down this ridge, as well as some backfire operations. As you mentioned, fire crews are really using this parking lot as ground zero for their firefighting efforts. You can see it's a lot different now. We've got residential cars as people come to the market. We've been seeing person after person come to the market here to get food, get supplies as they continue the rebuilding process. But folks also want to know how this fire started, and we're getting a little more information about what role PG&E might have played.
The United States Forest Service is looking into what caused the mosquito fire and is currently conducting a criminal investigation. According to a regulatory filing with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission this morning, the USFS removed and took possession of one of the utility's transmission poles and attached equipment this past Saturday, September 24th. This comes after an initial assessment showed that the mosquito fire started at the Oxbow Reservoir near a PG&E power line. The utility had previously reported that there was an outage in that area at that time. PG&E tells me the transition pole was replaced by a steel pole about 10 years ago. PG&E tells us they're cooperating with the U.S. Forest Service investigation and conducting their own investigation, but they say they do not have access to the seized equipment. While Forest Hill residents want to know what happened, they say they'll wait to reserve judgment until they get all the facts.
I don't have any right to blame anybody until I know what really, really happened. I mean, has it happened before? It has, but I don't get to say anything to PG&E as of yet.
Just last week, PG&E was named in a lawsuit that claimed that the utility had poorly maintained utility structures, again, in that area where the mosquito fire started. Reporting live in Forest Hill, Orko Manna, KCRA 3 News.
And Orko, we know the U.S. Forest Service is the lead agency looking into the cause of the mosquito fire. Do they have any updates today?
Well, I reached out to the U.S. Forest Service today, and they sent me a statement saying that they do not comment on pending legal issues or current investigations. Back to you.
All right. Orko Manna live for us in Forest Hill, right across from where the fire began. Thanks so much.